This is the question. Are you Christian, by the way?
I'm Christian.
Okay. This is the question. Would the Christian man marry a divorced Christian woman?
Sorry?
Would a Christian man...
Whose question is that?
I'm asking. It's my question.
That's not your question. So that's from the Google shit question.
Sorry? It's a shit question.
Google shit question. Ask me your question. Your own question.
Yeah, it is from the Bible.
What?
You should know, by the way.
What is the question? Why are you asking?
Because in Christianity, according to this, there's no respect for the
according
divorce.
According to what?
According to your Bible.
What is that reference?
Luke 16:18.
So what is the chapter talks about?
Well, you should know. You are the
what
Christian
is the chapter
person.
Talks about?
You are the Christian.
Don't play that victim game. No, what is the chapter talk
game.
About?
I'm talking and you should answer.
What is the chapter is talking about?
If you don't want to answer, you can tell me. I don't
what is the chapter is talking about?
I don't know.
So you don't know?
No, I don't know.
You just picked the picture from Google and you are reading the picture to me. You deserve no answer from me.
There's no answer.
You deserve no answer from me.
So I don't deserve no answer?
Yes, you deserve no answer.
Anyone has it? You're mocking people and the karma will hit you.
I thought you were Muslim. I thought you were Muslim. You believe in karma? You believe in karma?
I believe in karma.
100%
I believe in karma.
Did you do your homework?
You're Muslim and you're Muslim.
Did you do your homework?
He's converted. He's converted. He's converted.
Maybe you deserve
to do your homework, sir.
100%.
We have to live together.
Did you become ashamed of Islam?
No. Together.
Then explain it to me.
I'm proud to be Muslim. No, I'm proud.
What kind of proud Muslim that you can't even defend Islam? Proud Muslim?
This is Christian. You're Muslim. He's a Jewish. This is religion. We have to live together.
So there are some verses in the Quran. As a woman, I am very much disturbed.
Do you believe?
So, one of the verses in the background, when you look at it, it is talking about husband can have sex with the wife, however, whenever he wants. That's one of the verses. Another verse is talking about husband can be the wife. And then also there is another verse. It's talking about man can marry with a child who is yet to have her period. As I read those verses, I'm a Christian woman, and I am very much disturbed. I am very much disturbed with those teachings because it tells me Islam steps in and then takes the value and dignity of woman. As a Muslim woman, how do you justify those verses?
But we are families.
And what's your name, by the way?
We have to live love. Together. That's mother of me. That's law. That Jesus said, Israel, woman, Moses, but you said love. Love. We have to love each other.
I think there is a misunderstanding.
You are Muslim, you are Christian, everybody is really Christian. No. You have to live love. Love, that's all.
The interpretation of man can beat his wife is dark. If he's absent with his wife, say it's dark. Dark in Islam and Muslim at that time, in that tribe and in that time, it means to go out and go out by yourself and have a time by yourself. And when
let me understand. So, you are aware of the Surah 4 verse 34, which is talking about beating the wife, because the language of the Quran is Arabic. When you look at the word Arabic which has been used there is go out and take your space.
Yeah, because at that time when they say daraba al-khala, it means go out and to think about the problem and then come back. It doesn't mean hit your wife, because in Islam you can't hit anybody. In Islam you can't hit anybody. Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he never hit anybody. Even there is a people from other religions, they used to put tears when he pray, they put bad things. He never do anything to them, you know. And even the lady who used to put the tears in front of him, and he's a very well-known man at that time, and he's a prophet. 3 days he didn't put anything. And then he asked, what is that lady? I know that the lady is ill, she's sick. He went and visited that lady, and the lady became a Muslim. Anyway, sister,
so let,
I'm telling you.
So let me give you some response.
You can check in Google.
Ma'am, just a moment. Okay. I have done my homework, and according to my homework agrees with the current translation, which is beat, okay? Even this is translated by Muslims, okay? In here, it has been translated as the strike. So, now, are you able to produce me any dictionary that word Daraba means go out?
I give you mine.
I don't want to give you my number.
Okay. I want you to give mine. But it is meaning that. It's meaning.
Sorry, I'm just gonna show you. I'm just gonna show you the dictionary.
Yes, right.
So here's the dictionary. Here's the dictionary for the Daraba. Okay. He struck him 100 strokes with of the whip. Okay. I smote his neck, meaning I beheaded him. Okay. Strike off the head. So in here, or strike of a whip. There is nothing in this dictionary definition, this is lexicon, implies Daraba means, you can read all of them, so individual is going out and taking her space, okay? So, therefore, all I am telling is, the interpretation you gave it to me is not Islamic.
It is.
Here's the dictionary, just a moment, ma'am. Here's the dictionary, and according to dictionary, that's not the case. Even according to context, it wouldn't make a sense. Because you advise them, you forsake them from the bed, and then you beat them.
No, you leave the bed. Yes?
And same word has been
and
used
in... what sort of women? He mentioned that woman. This woman who brings something bad, or do something bad, you have to leave the bed, and then after that, go out. Daraba means go out. And
I did already give you the dictionary. I already gave you the dictionary. According to the dictionary, that is not the case, okay? And even if you allowed Quran to interpret it itself, okay? Same word used in Surah 8 verse 12, okay? And in Surah 8 verse 12, it says, so strike upon the necks and strike them from every fingertips. So there is no place, Quran allows, let me finish, Quran allows that word, Daraba, to mean go out and have your space. Okay, that's first point. Second point is,
go out, take your time, your wife.
Second point is, I show you the dictionary. Ma'am, just a moment. If the dictionary is correct and the Quran is correct, okay, if it is physically means beat, okay, or just a moment, if it is, and then whip them, okay, would you have a problem with that?
Yes.
What would you be your problem?
No, I will not be happy.
Why?
I will not be happy. If, you know, there is nothing, I did nothing, and maybe in an argument, I had argument with my husband, and he just, go away, I will accept it. But beat me, I won't accept it. But it means, the word Daraba, it has a lot of meaning.
No.
Go out.
No, so, there is no way in this sentence it has been used as go out and take your space. Okay? I already showed you.
No,
ma'am, I already showed you the dictionary.
You know,
and I already showed the same word which has been used in Surah 8 verse 12. So, all I wanted to know is that you have a problem with this. And you need to give up Islam because this is one of the basic issues.
Did you have the translation of one of the Muslim who translated
the Quran? This is from translated by Muslim. Sahih International Translation.
Next Sunday, I will come and talk to you about this.
Okay.
I will show you evidence because you didn't give me your number.
Okay.
I'm happy to give you my number.
No, I don't want to take your number. I don't want to give my number as well. but
more happy.
Yeah.
But,
so.
You, but
yeah, but bring your evidence and then we talk from that, because I already showed you the dictionary and you express that if it is true that you have a problem with it. Okay. So now, let me bring up the other problem I have.
Yeah, with the marriage.
Would you be happy for your husband to have sex with you without your permission?
Sisters, I told you this lady, she's an evil lady.
Without my permission, is there a thing mentioned, a boy in life, whenever he wants you to come, show me the surah or the ayah.
No, I'm asking, before I bring up the surah, I'm asking the basic question. Would you have a problem if your husband had sex with you, however, whenever he wants, then you don't want it?
I think this is like something should happen, you know, if you are happy and you are, have no problem together. But if he wants, I will sleep. I'm not feeling that thing now and something like that. But if he insists, I think I won't like it and I will tell him.
But if he wants to have sex with you, are you aware that Islam allows him to do so if you don't want him?
But I, you know, sister, the big thing is how you translate the Quran and how you translate the Christianity.
Okay.
And how
explain, Surah 2, Surah 2, 223 is the verse I'm talking.
Let me tell you something big. Something big. If you like it, that's it. If you don't like it, you are free. At the end of the day, the God is one. God is one. At the end of the day, God is one. He sent the Torah. He sent the Christianity book. Okay? And he sent the Quran. All at the period of time, here, to tell people about him and the universe, his creation, the way of life, everything. Moses is a prophet, okay? And Jesus is a prophet in Islam. And there is a surah for many. Muhammad is a prophet. All of them are prophets. They are messengers. Just take the word of God and bring it to us to learn the way and everything. And some people, they believe that Jesus is the Son of God. But if we believe Jesus is the Son of God, who is Adam? Adam has no mother and no father.
Ma'am, let me just make a point. So far, you were intentional to not engage with the arguments I brought it to you regarding the raping your wife, okay? But you want to talk about overall of Islam.
I want to talk about Islam.
Ma'am, just a moment. Ma'am, I listened to you. I listened to you, okay? And now I'm going to respond. So, you said you believe... Ma'am, I need you to listen now because I listened to you, okay? You express that you believe in all the books, and now you told me Jesus is just a prophet, but some people believe Jesus is the Son of God. The books you believe, which is including the Bible, according to the Bible, Jesus is the eternal Son of God. Okay? So therefore, why do you call my God just a prophet if you believe all the books?
Because the Christianity book is not the same one, it's changed.
But you said you believe all of them.
Yeah, so, the original ones.
So where are they?
But they have been changed.
Excuse me, who tells you they are changed?
You know, we know that they are changed. Because
who tells? Ma'am, focus. You need to focus, you need to give me your full attention, okay? Because you are making a claim about my eternity now, okay? So, where is it in the Quran tells you my scripture is being corrupted?
Yeah, in Quran it says, "Qul huwa Allahu ahad." God is one.
No. Ma'am, listen. I am not asking you to recite Surah 112 for me, okay? I am asking you to tell me, where does it in the Quran, it tells you my scripture has been changed and corrupted? That's That's not my question. So you told me my scripture has been changed and corrupted.
Yeah,
so and you said you believe in my scripture, okay? So where does it in the Quran? It tells you that ma'am, focus. No, you've got the focus. Why you need the ma'am? Focus now, ma'am. Listen now. Listen very carefully. You need to give full focus now. The reason is because you are making a claim about my eternity, and without any shame, you are kind of on the lines of going to lie. Okay? I don't want you to lie and bring shame to Islam. Therefore, I'll ask my question again. Where is it in the Quran, okay, Christian scripture is identified as corrupted and not reliable?
You know, in Quran it mentions that
right.
Some people, they change the Quran or they change other religions.
Where?
Okay.
Where is it in the Quran?
You know, you have, I don't know which surah, but there
give
is.
Give me the surah.
I'm not sure about the surah, but it's there.
It's not that.
Some
it's not
people,
that.
They write.
It's not that.
They change.
It's not that. There is no verse in the Quran tells you people change the Bible. There is no verse in the Quran tells you Bible is not reliable. So can you take that back? Can you apologize? Just a moment. I'm going to respond. Can you first apologize for lying about my scripture and then I answer your question regarding what I believe about Jesus?
I'm not going to apologize because God has no son.
That's not the part I am asking you to apologize. Ma'am, control yourself. Ma'am, control.
He doesn't need a mother. He doesn't need his God. He's unique. He creates everything.
My God doesn't need anything. Yes, you are correct. My God doesn't need me.
Ma'am, listen.
You need to listen now. Can I get your attention to listen? Okay? So tell me. According to Christian scripture, according to Islam, okay, why Jesus is not the Son of God?
Yeah. If you believe he's the Son of God.
Why, according to Islam, Jesus is not the Son of God?
According to Islam, he's not the Son of God because God mentioned in his book, in Quran, that he had no children at all.
He doesn't have children?
Yes.
What is the reason Allah doesn't have a children?
Because his God is unique.
So like I believe Jesus is the Son of God because before the foundation of the world, God the Father loves the Jesus. I believe Jesus is the Son of God because he claimed so and people took that as Jesus is making himself equal with the God. I believe Jesus is the Son of God because Jesus claims to do so. I believe Jesus is the Son of God because therefore, according to John chapter 9, he blasphemed and he died on the cross for that. Now, my question.
And who put him in the cross?
Ma'am, focus now. Focus now.
Who put him in the cross?
Focus. According to Islam, ma'am, I need you to focus now. According to Islam, let me give you why Allah doesn't have a son. You know why Allah doesn't have a son? Because Allah is not handsome, Allah doesn't have girlfriends. Therefore, Allah doesn't have a son. So, Quranic understanding of the Son of God is people in the beings are come together and then they make baby Jesus. That's not what I believe according to my scripture, okay? So, Surah 6 verse 101 talks about Allah doesn't have a son. How could he have a son? He doesn't have a girlfriend. That's according to your book. So, according to Christian scripture, I don't even think Jesus is the Son of God in a biological sense. Jesus is the Son of God because that is his identity, that is his personal identity. I believe God the Father, God the Son, and God the Spirit. Jesus is the eternal Son of God. John chapter 5 tells me when Jesus claimed that he is the day of the Sabbath, people took that as Jesus making himself equal with God, and people took that as Jesus called God his Father. Therefore, he is unique Son of God.
Okay, if I agree with you, why a father put his son, people put his son in the cross, and he died on that cross?
Sorry, why did
why
father?
Why died on the cross?
And why Jesus died on the cross?
Father.
That's very good question.
For our sins.
Huh?
for your sin.
So
nobody I am, die for everybody
ma'am, focus.
For
you, you ask, your ma'am, sin, ma'am, ma'am,
sin,
ma'am,
my sin.
Ma'am,
why ma'am, the son of the God?
Can
die?
I get your attention? Your I want to explain. I heard her question, ma'am. I heard. I want to answer your question. That's very important question. It is very important question. Ma'am, I know Islam doesn't teach respect to other Muslims, but please, at speaker's corner, get on the line. So, that's very important question. That is very important question you ask, and I want to answer that.
Sister,
according to Christian scripture,
you are Christian, you are happy. Jesus is the Son
I want
of
to
God.
I want to answer your
I
question.
Love that.
It is very important you question you ask. I want to answer.
People.
I am Christian. I am Christian.
And
ma'am, you've got to listen, ma'am. Can I get your attention?
Respect his mother.
I need
Mary,
your attention. So,
he is not dying.
The reason. Let me respond. Let me respond. That's very important.
You know what we believe in? What did they put him in the cross?
Ma'am, I want to answer the question. I want to answer the question. Let me answer.